When we started the Mill Valley Film Festival, there was really no opportunity to see personal filmmakers, independent work, and international films that went beyond a few major directors.
You know, it's like this has been the place where a lot of alternative cultures have happened, a lot of innovation has happened, a lot of artists live here. So in addition to these kind of filmmakers, there are a lot of documentary makers, there are experimental filmmakers. I think in a way that the sensibility of the Mill Valley Film Festival kind of comes out of that time in California. There's something really, really important about understanding who we are as human beings through the stories that we tell. And one of the most important ways that we experience stories now is through film.
We started classes for young adults. It appeared to me that there was hundreds of thousands of hours worth of great film that had great stories and lessons to be told. And working with the schools and creating classes in filmmaking and classes where we could use film as part of a curriculum just seemed to make obvious sense.
CFI Education is a very diverse program that has two sections. One is film and story, and the other one is the use of film as an educational tool to teach about other things besides film. It's really important to the community that we send a well-informed and holistic youth population into adulthood. We hope that we are able to teach people all of those things effortlessly and kind of sometimes a little bit invisibly so that they can be integrated into the community in a great way.
And ultimately, we also felt that we needed to be a year-round organization. It was really all about looking at the mission to celebrate film as art and education, and how could we do that more? How could we grow it? And the idea of building our own home came into being. And of course, that home now is the Christopher B. Smith Raphael Film Center.
These are the kinds of films that are not screened as much theatrically. We look to show films that aren't as obvious, aren't as seen, and perhaps sometimes need a nonprofit organization behind it where we're not counting pennies. It's part of our service to the public to bring these films to light.
But we also look at the Raphael as a town hall. It's a place where people can not only see great cinema and many times works of art, but they also can see films that have tremendous content, that give a window to the world.
Being able to encourage young filmmakers or new filmmakers or even, you know, like any filmmakers, being able to offer a place for their work to be seen that's kind of safe. I think we've also really committed to a very high quality. So for instance, at the Raphael, it's a beautiful place. It's a place that really supports filmmakers.
I do think California Film Institute is a great gift to the community. Between the Mill Valley Film Festival and the Raphael, the programs we offer, we can present programs, we can present films with the filmmakers, we can present them in a way that commercial theaters really aren't adapted to.
CFI is basically a place where we curate, we choose, we broker conversations with people in many ways throughout our community and communities.